हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल द ट्यूशन सेंटर। स्टे बी सेफ एंड बी हेल्थी। इन टुडेस चैप्टर वी वुड बी कवरिंग हाउ टू क्रिएट एक्सप्रेशन प्रॉपर्टीज। सो व्हाट आर एक्सप्रेशन प्रॉपर्टीज? एक्सप्रेशन प्रॉपर्टीज आर वेरी इसेंशियल बेसिकली व्हेनेवर वी नीड टू edit our text or color and need the same type of animation in multiple things, or if you want to change certain text in our pre-comp or in our pre-composition, and there are multiplications of text which we need to change. So we can create our properties and then we can work on that. So to start with, let's create the composition. And let's create some animation in it. So to start, let's create a solid or let's create a shape and then write a text in it, and then let's see. So to create text we would be using our rectangular tool. So press on Q to activate it and make a shape. Shape we are using so that we can define the properties and then we can change the color in pre-composition without even touching the main composition. Let's duplicate it. Let's create a text underneath. Let's change the color of this shape by pressing on the fill color icon. Let's create a text layer and let's type whatever you want to type. And let's take the text layer on the yellow bar we have created. Let's increase the size of our text layer. Let's duplicate the text layer and write one more text for the bottom bar we have created. Founder the Fusion Center. Let's reduce the size of this text. Let's change the color. Let's click on the move tool and drag your text on the blue bar. So as I always say, always remember to save your project. So let's save the project. Let's learn the editing. And let's do animation on it so that we can see that whenever we move anything from X part to Y part, the texts are changed. So let's start with the animation. Let's create our keys for the animation. Rectangular. Rectangular path. And let's position the path. Drag your path towards your same way. Let's go to the bottom shape. Let's again create the path. Let's move the keyframe again. Let's edit it and let's do it. So now our shape is animated. Now what we need to do is we need to animate our text. So let's select the layer Gaurav. Let's go to animation and let's slow fade. Click on view, select the key and move the key. Have come to around 9 frames. In the same way, let's create our first key. Next key, let's go to 0.0, let's go in 0.0. Now when Gaurav comes, you can see when the yellow shape layer is coming, the Gaurav is already in. So let's shift Gaurav a little bit. In the same way, let's shift our blue part forward and then the text layer on it, let's move it forward. Now let's see the animation. So now this is the animation which we have created. Now as we have talked about that we would be creating expressions, so this is very important. And whenever you use it in future, it will save your time, lots of time. It's like a bonus learning today, which would be helping you in your entire career. So to create, let's pre-comp it and name it Supers. Now as we have in Inters, we have learned how to pre-comp. So to the shortcut to pre-comp is Command Shift and C, and all the layer would merge into one. Now to create expression, go into this, click on this two arrows and go into Essential Graphics. So this is the window which is known as Essential Graphics, through which you would be creating expression. So the first thing first, let's select our mask and then click on solo. Now we need to add our things which we need to edit. So let's go on to our previous layer. Now for example, if we think that we need to change colors of this, so what we have to do is we have to open the transform properties, go to rectangle, go to fill, and here you can see the yellow color. So you need to add that to your essential properties so that it's visible on your composition. So let's open, reveal in source, click essential properties, click on the transform content rectangle. And fill. Now here you need to click And here you can see add properties to essential graphics. So when you click on add properties of your essentials, so here it has come which says blue color. So let's name it BLUCOLO. In the similar way, you need to add the yellow rectangle content also to your essentials property. So let's open it, let's go to color and click on add essential properties and name it. So now what else do you want to edit? So now, for example, if you want to edit your text, so open the text, click and add to essentials properties. So it says in the same way, let's click on founder, click on text, click and add to essential properties, and let's name it definition. So now we have added all our layers in our essentials graphics pro box, and let's see what all changes have it made to our precom window. Now when you go to your precom window, so here you can see one more dialog box which have been added to your layer, which was not previously, it was not there. So the dialog box says master properties. So let's open it and see what all new things we have got. So as we open our dialog box, it says blue color, yellow, top name and designation. Plus if we go to point zero and if we play it, we can see that the animation is there in our text. Now if I want to, for example, if I want to change my blue bottom color, to say yellow. So I can do that now. Plus, if I need to change my text, so for example, if I need to write tuition center before and then the founder, and let's click OK. So now we can see that the tuition center is in the beginning. And your founder is towards the end. In the same way, if you want to edit the value of this, you can go on and you can write and click OK. So now you can see that Mr. Garg have been written. And now if you go into your precom, there is no change in it. Whereas if you have been doing, you must have been creating your precom again and again and then changing the things. Plus if you can see that we have written Gaurav Garg in caps, and when we have written here, you would have noticed that top name, we have simply written Mr. Garg, which was in a smaller case. But as the properties of Gaurav Garg is in uppercase, that's why it have also taken in the uppercase. Likewise, if for example, if I want to left align, so we can click here, and then we can align it. And now if you go to our com, you can see that Mr. Garg have been left aligned. Previously it have not been left aligned because it was central aligned in the master composition. So you can change the color, but the animation, the colors, and theme would be would remain the same for the supers and all. Now, what if you want to go back to the previous color? So you can see the icons here, which says pull from master com and push to master com. So what do you mean by pull from master com? Pull from master com means that when we click on here, the original color, the original shape, the original things would come in our existing com. Whereas if we click here, then this composition would transfer into our original composition. So let's first try this. So if we click here, so you can see that the original color have come back. Likewise, if we click here, you can see that it's pulling the data from the original com. Now many times there are list of supers and you don't want to do all this again and again. So we can also create an CSV file in Excel and save as CSV file, and then we can import that file and we can use that particular file to edit and to change the super from time to time. And it's very simple. You just have to create the columns, X number of columns which you need. So for example, in this case we need two columns. It says Gaurav Gargan, founder, the tuition center. So you can create the CSV file in any software you like to. So we have created one CSV file which we would be importing. So let's click here and let's import our CSV file. And let's bring this file to our composition. So now as you can see, we have imported our CSV file in our timeline. So what does it actually do? So let's first open our Excel and see what all data have we put in our Excel, so that we know what all things it will change when we do the thing. So let's open it. So now here you can see we have created two. Let's zoom in. So we have created two columns. One is name and second is age. And let's see what it does exactly does. So let's open the parameter. What all parameters have we received here? So as you can see, the first column was name and then the age. So same thing have been imported here, including the name and the age. So now here you can see name is in the first column and age is in the second column, and there are difference in age. So what you have to do is you have to click here and you have to align any of the supers which you want to. So for example, if I align name 1 to top and age 1 is 0 to designation. So let's see. So you can see that the age and the designation have been changed. The upper name have been left aligned, but the lower name have been central aligned. So it's because the main composition properties, if we go to the tuition center and if we go to the paragraph column, it says it's central aligned. So let's make it left aligned and align the text. Now let's see what changes have it done. So now you can see that it have aligned your text towards your left. In the same way, let's change the things and let's see what all does it do to the things. So by using the essentials, you can reduce your work. You can reduce your work to half. Thank you. Yeah. So you can try. Again, you can see push to master comp and back to master comp have been activated. So you can click here and you can see that it have been changed to the original composition. Let's click again. So again, your new the original composition is on your window. Let's play it. So how will it save your time? So for example, if we don't follow this method and we don't use essential graphics and create some master properties for our pre-composition, we again and again have to go to our original composition and text and change something there. First thing. Second thing, each and every time if we want something to change or if we want to go back to the things, we need to again and again duplicate our composition, then go to that thing and do the things. It's little bit lengthy process, and many time it have been seen or it have been experienced when we again and again change our pre-composition. Many time we make mistakes and the original lost, and it's very difficult to go back, and we have to start our entire thing from the beginning. So by using essential graphics, the colors, the text can be changed easily, and it can save your time, and it can be very helpful to you in the course of doing project or creating X number of super by using the same effects and all. So try it with the different type of animation, super, creating different essentials graphics. Now you know how to add your things to the essential graphics and how you can use them to the pre-com windows. So that's it for today. For me, it's very important to learn this. So if you find it useful, do leave your comment. Thank you very much. Feel free to ask anything you want to, or any particular type of things you want to cover in this channel. Thanks again. Keep watching. Stay at home and be safe and healthy. Hashtag share your knowledge. And do not forget to subscribe our channel and do forward to your friends. Thank you very much. That's it for today. So in today's chapter, we have learned how to create new composition, how to create basic animation, how to create shape layers, how to change the colors of the shape layer, how to use the text layer, how to pre-com more than one layer into one composition, how to create master properties and add things to essential graphics, how to